A giant asteroid is about to hit the Earth and kill us all.
Ow! Ow!
Hi guys, this is Artie and this is a new edition of my V Names video blog. As you can see, I'm wearing my cocky t-shirt now because today I'm gonna get cocky on all those myths about space. So people have been hyped about that space stuff recently, and not because a giant asteroid is about to hit the Earth and kill us all. And not because that new Star Wars movie is about to hit the screens, or, well, is it? I don't know. No, it's all about water, and it is pretty weird. Well, it's not just any water, it is water on Mars. So, researchers have found evidence of liquid water on Mars. They believe that there is a lake of water under Mars' South Polar ice cap. How did they find it? Radars study Mars' surface and subsurface by radars, and they examine everything that comes back. While doing that, researchers spotted something weird 1.5 kilometers under the ice, and it turned out to be water. So that means that there is life on Mars, and maybe we will be able to bring democracy on Mars. Or maybe Martians will try to bring democracy to Earth and turn us into their subservient little pets.
What the hell?
Out of the frying pan, dot dot dot, huh, Morty?
Oh man, what's going on?
Not really. There are many misconceptions about space that people still believe in. For example, that people explode in space without a suit. They don't. Hollywood came up with that one. Well, what really happens is that they die of suffocation because of the lack of air in space. Not explosion. Or there's another myth that you can see the Great Wall of China from space, and you can't. It's not true. You can't even see it from the low Earth orbit, 160 kilometers. You can't see it from the outer space either, because it basically blends in with the color and geography of the landscape around it. Sorry, I got kind of distracted. Back to Mars. There are lots and lots of misconceptions about Mars, but let's deal with that life on Mars thing. Is life on Mars possible? Maybe. To cook life, you basically need four ingredients. Energy. There are natural sources of energy like solar emissions and natural chemical reactions on Earth. Chemical elements. You need a large variety of chemical elements to produce chemical bonds and chemical reactions. Sustainable environment. It is necessary for constant chemical and, maybe later, biological processes. Finally, water. Liquid water. It has to be specifically liquid water. Why? Because only liquid water can serve as a universal dissolution medium. This medium lets chemicals get together and turn into different forms, and, if they're lucky enough, into life. So now we know that the last element from the list is present on Mars. Yet, sadly, there are some problems to be discussed. The thing is, Mars is really cold. And not like Russia cold. And not even like Antarctica cold. Much colder. Minus 68 degrees. Well then, how is it possible that there is liquid water on Mars, you might ask? The thing is that the freezing point of water on Mars is way lower than 0 degrees Celsius.
So salt makes ice melt faster, and that's why there is water on Mars. So, and I want to illustrate that with a little experiment. So I have ice in my left hand and I have salt in my right hand. Let's combine them together and see what happens. Let's go.
Ow!
Ow! Ow!
No. That shit, man. I'm not doing this anymore. It's stupid.
Why is it so? Because there are huge amounts of salts dissolved in water on Mars. There are sodium, magnesium, and calcium salts in it, and they reduce the melting point of water to minus 74 degrees Celsius. Better not to take your next vacation there. Summing it up, Mars is cold, Mars is lame, Mars is disgusting, and Mars is very, very salty. So it might be a bit of a hassle for organisms to develop. But what about us? Does the fact that there is liquid water on Mars mean that we can move there and live on Mars? Well, not really. We've long known that there is water on Mars in the form of ice caps. And since people can turn ice into water, the fact that there is liquid water on Mars doesn't really change anything for us. All of this doesn't mean that there could be life on Mars and that there wasn't previously. The fact that there is liquid water on Mars could help scientists learn more about Mars history. Yet, saying right now that there are definitely little Martians solely due to this fact is what they call an exaggeration. So, and what do you think about life on Mars? Is it better than Ziggy Stardust? Or do you like Aladdin Sane better? Well, no. Seriously, what do you think about life on Mars? Leave your opinion in the comment section, I will read it and I will maybe reply, but I can't promise anything. It's been me, RT, my new vlog. It has been a pleasure. All links are in the description box. Subscribe to all the social media and I will see you next time.
Come on. Come on. Stupid. Come on.